Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video. If you are into filmmaking, learning DaVinci Resolve, tips and tricks for filmmakers, and reviews, previews, and all of that nature, please consider subscribing for this channel. So in today's video, we're going to have a look at the Blackmagic ATEM Mini, which is a switcher done for switching your video feed, so you can either record into a recorder like the Blackmagic Video Assist, which I'm using sometimes, or you can stream directly to YouTube, Facebook, Twitch, whatever. And it should be just right out of the box plug and play thing. So let's figure that out. So we have the box here, and when we open the box, we do have some information cards. We are not so interested in those right now. Here we have the unit itself, and that's all there is in the packet. So as you see, the ATEM Mini doesn't come with a lot of stuff inside of the box. So if you want to live stream, you're going to need one of these guys here. And this is just a USB-C type cable to USB 3, because I'm on PC. And that is all you need to hook this up so you can live stream. So let's have a look at how this thing works. I'm not going to do a live stream, but I'm just going to do a recording. So we'll go to that right now. And let's see if this is fun using. Okay, so here we are using the ATEM Mini. So the setup here is pretty straightforward. Let's just cut to second camera. I have the ATEM Mini here. For my audio, I am using the mic one input, which is the Rode Wireless Go connected to that. And then of course I have the lavalier right here. And then I have, that is my audio setup. I'm not using the camera's audio, so I have that because you can control that here. Those are on off, all of those, and I'm not following the video, which you could do, but I am using the same audio source for all of it. So that is the audio portion of this. So inside of my ATEM here, I have, there is of course four inputs, 1, 2, 3, and 4. On my input number one, I have camera one, which is the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K. Right there. On my second camera, I have this shot here for the ATEM, and that is the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K, my second one. And on my third output, I do have my computer here. So I'll just go back here. And on my fourth input, I do not have anything. And then it is just, again, if you go to the output here, I have my three HDMI going to pocket one, pocket two, my computer output is here. And then I have a input, computer input is right here. And right here, I do have a output, and that is because I am recording this on my, and you can't see that in frame, on my Blackmagic Video Assist. And then of course also have the output here connecting this to the computer, so we can actually control this via the computer. So I'll just go to the computer screen here. So this is just the only thing I have done in here. This is just plugged right in right now. The only thing I've actually done in here is I've opened this software, which is the software, it can be found on Blackmagic Design's homepage. I haven't changed anything, but you could change things if you wanted to do some kind of program preview, but I have left this setting as it was from the beginning. So, and then I also got the, and also I got this thing here, which is the software portion of the ATEM Mini. And all I did change in here was to go down here to this wrench wheel here, and I changed the video output to 24 frames a second, because that's what my camera are doing. And that's actually all there is to the system. So let's just run through the rest of the system. So I'll just go to camera two here. We have some good, pretty good features already. So again, we can just quickly go to this. Again, all our inputs are here. Here we have all our audio, which are here. And then we have some effects. We have, for instance, picture in picture, which is up here. And I can just turn that on. And now you'll see that my camera one, per default, that's what it does. It takes the camera one input and make that the picture in picture. And I have four buttons, so I can move around my picture in picture pretty easy. I can turn it off if I want, turn it on, and if I cut to camera one, it will disappear. Then when I cut back to two, I'll just push on and it'll be right there. Super easy and convenient. Then we are also having some small transitions here. I'll just go here. Here we have the transitions you can do. So if you push auto, and let's say we want to have that you can change different durations. You can have like half a second, 1 second, 1.5 seconds, and 2 seconds for that slow fade. So if we want to do a transition, let's take this first one here. We'll push that. And when we push on one, we'll do a transition. And that was the slow transition. And as long as we are on the audio here, it will, we will have this transition. As soon as we just push cut, we are going back to a regular cut, which can make us cut through the things like we want. So this is a pretty fun little tool you have in your disposal. Let's just run through the different transitions, and we'll put those at 1 second. So we'll go to the second transition here, which is the same, but just from the top. We'll change transition again, and we'll go to the next transition, which is this slide. And of course we have here again, the other one, which is a squeeze. Okay, and of course we can also use a mix, which is just going to mix our, together with a fade, a slow fade. And that is of course, again, controlled with the seconds we want that to be. If we want it to be a bit faster, we would change that. Okay, and then of course the last thing we have is a dip. So we can just dip to white. Maybe we can change the color in the software, I'm not sure about that. And then we also have here a fade to black, which we can cut, and we'll fade to black, and we can push it again and go back. I'll go back to normal cut mode here. So let's just go into the software a second here, and I'm just going to picture in picture here. So we have the software here, and how that works is actually in reality, you don't really need the switcher because you can change this in the software here. I'm pushing on one and I'm going to camera one with the software, camera two, and back to camera three. Like so, and I still have my picture in picture here, so that's great. The interface of this, I mean, there is a lot of things you can do in here. I'm not going to go way deep into this, but there we have a media player where we can play some media stuff, but we're not going to mess around with that. Just the overall thing here is, I think it's that we, down here we have, this is the, if you are using DaVinci Resolve, the way this software is built up is pretty familiar to you. I think we have the switcher down here, then we have a media tab where we can put in our media. I haven't messed around with this at all because this is my first time actually trying this thing. So I want to do more in depth about that, I think. And then we have the audio portion of this as well. And if you are, again, using DaVinci Resolve, this ought to be a little bit familiar to you, at least if you're using the Fairlight, because that is, again, how we can control things here. So let's, we can mess around with the mixer a bit. I just need to take on my headphones here. And let's see if we can hear anything. And we have to put them the right way, otherwise it's going to be very, very strange. Okay, so we are in here in the ATEM software here, and if we go to our mic one, we can put in an equalizer pretty easy, put in some bands. That's what we do in, I'm just going to put myself out of this frame. And then we can, for instance, let's change the frequency and we can, let's give it a little boost here. And then with the Q factor, we are going to gain. And then of course we can swipe if we want to make it sound better. Like something like, and then we can drag that down in the gain. So that is working pretty much what like you would expect. And now it sounds terrible, but that's okay. Because there is something here that doesn't sound great. We are going to drag that out. We can then also boost our stuff a bit. Something like this. Now we have done something and we can just turn that off pretty fast here. So now you can hear the difference if we do something. Cool, let's turn that off. And then of course we also have a dynamics, which is exactly the same as in Fairlight. Again, we have here we have the input and this is the output. So we could, for instance, put in a limiter and boost up the threshold for that a bit, give it a little more power boost here, so it'll be around here, and then we can put on a compressor as well, and we will compress it like so. We can put in a gate if we have some noise we don't want, and as you can see, we can change that around like so. Again, a nice thing to have here, nice to know that it's there. And then we can just reset everything back to normal if we want to. Okay, so that's again how that thing works. So one thing, I'll just take off my headphones. Totally forgot that I had those on. So you might think, why do you need to have a ATEM Mini? What purpose does this have for you? And I can only speak for what I think. So what I think, this little thing here, which is, by the way, it's $300. It's super cheap, it's super affordable, and it is actually, when you think about it, a couple of years ago, if you wanted to have a camera connected to your computer, you needed to have a lot of capture cards and stuff. And the price of that would be way more than the price of this. And then you are not even able to do like a multicam switch, which I'm able to do now. So who do I think this thing is for? This thing would be great if you are doing a small concert and you want to do a multicam edit right about, you know, on the go, and then just record it directly into something like a Blackmagic Video Assist. Or it will also be super great if you are doing some kind of a live stream. That's of course what this is actually meant to, but this is like giving people the power to do live stream super affordable, super easy. I mean, it's for me, there's no problem connecting cameras to this thing because it will do all of those things automatically by itself. I think that is really great. And then also, like, if I have to think about the purpose that I would use this for, I mean, for me, it would be great if I could do my tutorials like this, for instance, live, in some kind of a way, because it would save me time. Again, it is just a, for me, this is the first time for me trying this out. This is also my first switching done here. So that is kind of neat and it's kind of easy. So I think I will do some follow-up videos about this little piece of equipment. Mostly, I want to figure out how I can do this with the pictures or how to get media into the system. I think that would be great. I also want to explore the ability to live stream with this setup or a similar setup. Even though for me, live streaming is a bit daunting because I know how much editing I actually do on my videos. I cut out a lot of me rambling, and doing live would be kind of intimidating to me. But well, we have to try new things, right? Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it will help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on the channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing. Bye. Fade to black.